Today, I'm going to show you my mobile 360 video editing setup with MacBook Pro, eGPU, and the latest Adobe Premiere Performance Boost on this unique setup. I was on a 4-month travel VR filmmaking job that requires me to shoot and finish the video on the road. And this setup allows me to do just that. Are you a MacBook Pro video editor feeling your Mac is not fast enough? This is the video for you. Let's dive in. What's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Create Up, your one-stop shop for professional 360 VR productions. I got lots of requests from my computer setup, and lots of you guys are still in love with your MacBook Pro and want to stay in all Mac workflow. I feel you. I'm also a hardcore Apple fan. I use iPhone, iPad, as well as the latest MacBook Pro.
Hello.
Mac?
And I'm a PC. You know, I actually just finished a
360
movie.
That's so funny, I just finished my own home movie. I did it on
Premiere.
It was really easy.
Well, I doubt it's as excellent as mine, but I'd be happy to take a look.
Yeah, that would be great. Okay,
roll it.
Hi, so. I'm a Mac.
360.
It looks
great. Bye.
Wait.
What
about yours? Can we see yours?
Please.
Well, okay, sure.
What's up, PC?
360. So you ask, why your Mac is so slow when handling 360 video editing? Well, if you have a deep pocket and just want the absolute raw power, I would still recommend my PC desktop setup from Main Gear. The review and build of this powerful PC is coming up in the next tutorial. But having a mobile 360 solution is very necessary for VR documentary filmmakers, especially for those of you that require to edit on the road. Having a PC tower travel with you is unpractical. And some of those gaming laptops are way too heavy and honestly way too ugly. So, if you decide to stick to your MacBook Pro, here is what I'm going to recommend. Getting a eGPU to supercharge it. I have the latest MacBook Pro, and here is my spec. But eGPU setup work on any MacBook Pro, including your 13-inch one, as long as you have Thunderbolt 3 connection. So let's take a step back. Why Thunderbolt 3 is an absolute must? Well, as a travel VR filmmaker, it's easier to have terabyte of footage a day with professional VR camera like the Insta360 Pro 2, Kandao Obsidian, and the upcoming Titan right here, or using two Red Epic W with fisheye lenses. So having a RAID 0 travel drive like the G Shuttle XL or Lazy 6 Big with Thunderbolt 3 connection is essential. Thunderbolt 3 has 40 GB per second speed that guarantees your hard drive is not the bottleneck of your entire post pipeline. Sorry, I'm off topic here, but this is very important. You want to remove all your bottlenecks from your rendering pipeline. And hard drive write speed is always forgotten and will make your life a living hell when you come to rendering. I will have a tutorial to explain all that, so let's move on. Thunderbolt 3 is also essential for eGPU. That is how Apple designed to provide you the graphic power you need. So, there are actually two paths of using eGPU with your Mac system. The obvious way is to turn your Mac into a window machine using Bootcamp and run NVIDIA graphic card like the GTX 1080 Ti. Basically, using your MacBook Pro like a desktop PC at home. Here, right here, I have the Razer Core X eGPU enclosure with the GTX 1080 Ti in it. It does provide great power on graphic processing, and I can play Beat Saber with my MacBook Pro.
Pew 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 pew
Well, if playing Beat Saber is what you want. For professional video works, using Windows on a Mac machine is extremely unstable. I'm speaking from a first-hand experience, guys. The Windows system keep crashing during Premiere Render or just anything if heavy graphics is involved. So even with raw power, without stability, it's not gonna work. Especially in VR, when long rendering time is often required. So we pick the safe path, using Mac as it intends to be used. But don't fall for the Mac commercial and get the Blackmagic eGPU, which is the worst and expensive investment. That eGPU is not powerful enough for VR or any high-end video work. So what should you choose? First, let's figure out the GPU. I have an old AMD Radeon MX 1700, which is built for the desktop VR. It's very cheap and you can easily find a setup that is way cheaper than and more powerful than the Blackmagic eGPU bundle. But don't stop there. Now you know my idea. We are going to get an affordable solution with desktop workstation great processing power, but not to replace your desktop PC at home. Yes, you can certainly go with the Radeon MX 9100.
It's over 9,000!
Which is 16GB VRAM and costs around $1,500. But that is overkill for a mobile workflow as your CPU and RAM is not gonna use all its power. So we picked the middle ground. The brand new AMD Radeon Vegas MX 8200.
It's over 8,000!
Here is some impressive comparison of the MX 8200 in an 8K to 4K rendering within Adobe Premiere Pro 2019. As you see, its performance is close to NVIDIA RTX 2080 Ti, which is ridiculous for a less than $1,000 graphic card. But there is a catch. Not all eGPU enclosure will work with the Radeon MX 8200s in a plug-and-play manner with your MacBook Pro. I tested all the available eGPU enclosure in the market, and the best one is from a California-based company, the Sonet EGFX Breakaway Box 650. Right here, power my MacBook Pro right now. Spoiler alert, Adobe is working on a performance improvement in their software to support this particular eGPU setup with AMD. So if you are using Adobe Premiere Pro, which is 90% of the VR editors out there, you will see an insignificant performance boost. Let's take a look at some real life example. So now we are in Premiere 2019. The first one we're gonna show you is some Insta360 Evo footage in 5.7K. It's an MP4 file. I'm also running screen recording right now. So let's see how good is the render, the preview. Go ahead and hit play. As you see, we have no drop frame and the playback is super smooth, and that's 5.7K in the Evo footage live right now. Great. Okay, next one I'm gonna show you is directly from my Otomo Ninja Inferno for my GH5. The record format is ProRes 422 HQ. And go ahead and check out the footage. It's in full resolution again, and we got no drop frame and playback smoothly. The next one is kind of crazy. We have the Insta360 Titan, which is 8K 10-bit, and it is also in ProRes 422. And let's see how smooth the playback. Yes, we have drop frame, but if you pay attention to me walking around, the movement is pretty smooth, it's totally okay for edit, and we are in full resolution in 8K 10-bit, which is pretty insane. Last one I want to show you is directly from the Red website. It's the Red Epic W with the 8K Helium sensor. That is the original Red RAW file. It's not even ProRes. And we had to drop this into 1:4 quality, and let's go ahead and play it. And we also got real-time, no drop frame playback. Thank you for watching. As always, if you have any question, please comment below. I will do my best to answer them, and I hope my other viewers will jump in and help you as well. I just launched my first episode of the Meet the Determined VR docu-series. I want to show you the trailer now, and I need your love. Watch it in your favorite VR headset. Like and share that video. Let me know what you think and how I can improve my VR filmmaking skills. And here is the trailer.
My name is Lily. I'm from London and I play tennis. When I'm playing tennis, I feel excited, happy, proud. I like to win.
Lily's been around tennis basically all her life. She started taking it seriously when she was 12, but when she was much younger, she played with her brother and I hit with her. And yeah, she's been in and out of tennis all her life.
Lily's really tenacious. She doesn't ever complain about being tired. I think I have to decide when she's tired. She keeps running all the time. Tennis obsessed, just like me.